So this is the last, the fourth video for chapter one, and we just have a little bit more information, background information in the world of geology. So let's think about the Earth's surface and the major features that we see. And if you think about that, our major features are the oceans and the continents. The elevation varies for ocean basins and continents, as well as their densities and thicknesses. If we look overall, the ocean basins average a depth of 3.8 kilometers, whereas the thickness of the basaltic rocks making up the ocean basins are approximately 7 kilometers thick. Now, continents are the other major features we see, and averaging 0.8 kilometers above sea level, composed of granodiorite or granitic type of rocks, averaging 35 kilometers in thickness. So those are some major features overall on our Earth. We take a look from space, we look down, we see ocean, and we see continents. Ocean basins average a depth of 3.8 kilometers. And are composed of basaltic rocks averaging a 7 kilometer thickness. Continents, on the other hand, are 0.8 kilometers average height above sea level, composed of a granitic type of composition and averaging 35 kilometers in thickness. Let's start with a detailed look at our ocean floors. One feature is called the continental margin. And that's the portion of the seafloor right next to the continent itself. And so along the margin, we start, if we were to walk out into the ocean, you would walk onto the continental shelf. Then there would be a break of about 3 to 6 degree slope, what we call the continental slope. And then at the bottom of the continental slope, we have the rise, which is slightly less steep than the slope, and then we get out into the deep ocean. So along the margins, we can define areas as the shelf, the slope, and the rise. So this is from the continental margin out into the ocean. Once you get past that continental rise, you enter the deep ocean basins where there are abyssal plains. These are flat features. There are trenches, which are deep, narrow depressions. And the seamounts are small volcanic structures that scatter the ocean floor. Another prominent feature of oceans are the ocean ridges that wind through all ocean basins. And they are composed of igneous rock that has been fractured and uplifted. Here is an image of our ocean basins and our continents. And this is an example of a ridge. We call this the Mid-Atlantic Ridge that runs all through the Atlantic Ocean Basin, and you can see how that just winds around, and all ocean basins have ridge systems. Here's the East Pacific Rise, a portion going through a section I'm showing here of the East Pacific Rise of the Pacific Ocean. Let's move on to the continents and the major features. We have flat areas, and we have elevated areas. So our mountain belts are obviously our elevated areas, very prominent on the continents. And then the stable interiors of continents we call cratons. Now, a craton can be broken down into shields, which are flat regions of crystalline rock, that is igneous and metamorphic, very, very old. And then our stable platforms are the area of cratons where that shield has been covered up by a thin veneer of sedimentary rocks. So cratons can be divided into shield portions and stable platforms. So in Missouri, do you think that you live on a shield or a stable platform? We actually live on a stable flat platform. We are covered with a thin veneer of sedimentary rocks. Here we have an image showing our major mountain areas and our shield areas. And yellows represent young mountains. They're defining as less than 100 million years old. So the Andes and the North American Cordillera are examples. Alps, Himalayas, these are all very young mountains, relatively speaking. Whereas the Appalachians, that Caledonian, these are old mountain belts. As far as the craton goes, the shield, the Canadian shield, exists up in this area and consists of very old, highly deformed igneous and metamorphic rocks. And then our stable platform, you can see that Missouri would exist in the stable platform. So the igneous and metamorphic rocks are there, it's just they're covered up by sedimentary rocks. So you can see more platforms, shields. Look at the African shield, how large it is, the Brazilian shield. All right. So some of these structures are quite large. And that concludes our Chapter 1 overview. And our next series of lectures will be covering Chapter 2 on plate tectonics.